Hello again, everybody. Welcome back to Enjoy English School. I'm Bruce.
I'm Anthony.
Today, in our Spotlight on Taiwan section, every month we take a close look at some place in Taiwan. Sometimes you probably have visited it with your family or certainly have seen it in magazines or television programs, but we like to introduce something special about these places.And today we're going to San Yi and see Taiwan's wood carving capital.
没错，又到了我们深入台湾的单元了。我们今天要带各位到台湾的哪里去玩呢？我们要带大家去苗栗的三义。我们来看一下我们的 title 哦，走访三义，寻觅木雕之美。它的那个英文的 title 是三义 Taiwan's wood carving capital.Capital 就是首都的意思，那 wood carving 就是木雕。
Okay, our subtitle after San Yi, Taiwan's wood carving capital is Discover how wood carving took root in San Yi. Discover is to find something out for the first time. Wood carving, he already explained to you. And this is so clever, they say to take root in San Yi.Root is, if this is the ground and you have a plant like a tree here, underneath are the roots. And we use the expression to take root means something begins and then develops. And in this case, wood carving, maybe 300 years ago, was not part of San Yi's economy. But it is now. It has taken root, and we're going to find out how today.
没错，所以在这里的话用 take root 这个字来表达跟这个木雕的形象，很多时候 木头嘛，在树成长的时候它要向下扎根，所以用这个意象的话是非常准确的。我们来赶快看看今天内容吧。
San Yi, Taiwan's wood carving capital. San Yi, a town located in central Taiwan's Miaoli County,is famous for wood carving. San Yi's wood carving industry dates back to the early 1900s, when the Japanese colonial government began harvesting camphor trees in the area. After the harvest, the Japanese government decided to use the area to plant tea trees. However, workers first had to remove huge roots that were left in the groundfrom the old camphor forest. These roots provided artists with natural materials to carve all sorts of amazing things. Wood carving in San Yi broke new ground in the 1940s thanks to a man named Liu Dechun. One cold winter day, he turned a simple wooden mortar into a Japanese-style hibachi by adding a copper plate.This practical design was popular in Japan. Leo's success allowed him to set up a store known as the Baiji Store in 1945. In addition to works of art, San Yi's woodworking industry was commercially successful in selling practical items like furniture and plates. In the 1950s and 1960s,San Yi was a popular tourist spot for American soldiers who were stationed in nearby Taichung. During that time, San Yi became famous for its wooden sculptures, which made great souvenirs.
San Yi, a town located in central Taiwan's Miaoli County,is famous for wood carving. Now, if you live or visit or have gone through Miaoli, you may have stopped there, and sooner or later, you may wonder, wow, look at all these carved pieces of woods in all of these stores that sell this kind of thing. So we can refer to San Yi, as we do in the title, as a wood carving capital. It's a town which...has a primary industry, a most important industry to that town. And in the case of Miaoli, it is wood carving, and we'll tell you what kind of wood in a moment.
嗯，没错，所以在这里老师刚刚用到一个字叫做 primary， primary 就是主要的意思，最主要的一个 industry 产业。 primary 这个字的拼法是 P-R-I-M-A-R-Y， primary 就是最主要的。我们来看一下第一段的第一句话，他说三义 a town located in central Taiwan's Miaoli County， 指的就是指好的三义呢是在台湾中部苗栗县的一个小镇，然后呢is famous for wood carving， 好，是以木雕来闻名的。
Sani's wood carving industry dates back to the early 1900s when the Japanese colonial government began harvesting camphor trees in the area. So we now find out that in the early 1900s, that's about 100 years ago, Japan came to Taiwan in 1890?
差不多。
1895, maybe?
Yeah.
And it wasn't long after that, they found out that the camphor tree grew plentifully in many places in Taiwan. You can easily find camphor trees up here in Taipei, but Miaoli had forests of these trees, and the wood is prized, is appreciated,and developed into products wherever it is grown. And they made it an industry because of the number of trees. A lot of people could be involved in the primary industry of wood carving.
嗯，没错。所以在老师刚刚提到说，在1895年之后，日本人到了台湾来殖民了呢，他发现到中台湾有非常非常多林木的资源哦。可能你有听过像是苗栗啦，好，樟树很多，或者像是在嘉义阿里山啦，他们还特别坐这个小火车要把这些木材运出来嘛，好，运出来。所以在这里的话，我们看到第二句话，他说 Sunny's wood carving industry， 哦，这个字 industry 我们刚刚就提到了，就是产业的意思，木雕产业 dates back to the early 1900s， 好，它能够追溯到二十世纪初期的这个时候，那个时候怎么样呢？它逗号后面就告诉你它这个时间怎么样。When the Japanese colonial government 这个日本的殖民政府呢 began harvesting camphor trees in the area， camphor trees 就是我们知道的樟树，好，他们就在这个地方呢开始这种开采这些樟树，采伐这些樟树，然后呢，它在这个地方就是 in the area。
After the harvest, the Japanese government decided to use the area to plant tea trees. Now notice harvest. It doesn't matter what you grow, what kind of plant you grow. If you cut it down to use it, to eat it, to carve it, to burn it, whatever, you can use the word to harvest this kind of tree or to harvest a forest. The camphor trees were so plentiful that... After they cut them all down, they were very valuable. Why waste this land? So they could plant something else there that maybe was easier to harvest than cutting down a big tree. And they decided on tea, which is a favorite drink and plant in Japan.
嗯，没错，所以这里的话告诉我们就说了，他说在这个采收完之后 after the harvest， 老师刚刚提到这个 harvest 这个字是采收嘛，任何的这种作物啦 crops、哦、那种很多 crop 通常会加 s 指的是这些作物，你都可以使用 harvest 这个字采收来表达。所以在采收完这些樟树之后呢， the Japanese government decided to use the area to plant tea trees，那采收完之后，这块土地放着不用白不用嘛，所以干脆呢，怎么样？他就打算在这个地方开始种茶树。
However, workers first had to remove huge roots that were left in the ground from the old camphor forest. I said before, if this is the earth, and up here is your tree or your rice or your tea, some kind of plant.It has roots going down into the earth, under the earth. Well, of course, trees have very large and hard roots.
嗯，没错。所以这里的话，我们看到一个很熟悉的字，叫做 roots。 那我们刚刚在副标题里面说 take root, 对不对？好，用到这个字。那在这里的话，这个 roots 就是这个树的根。那今天如果你这个土地要种茶树，那势必要把里面的这些樟树的根都把它挖出来嘛。所以这句话就说了 ,however, workers first had to remove 就是移走，对不对？ remove huge roots that were left in the ground from the old camphor forest. 所以在当初砍完樟树之后，剩下那些树根在底下，地底下的，要想办法把它移出来之后，才能够继续种植茶树。
These roots provided artists with natural materials to carve all sorts of amazing things. Well, I find the people in Taiwan to be very practical. They don't waste very much at all. And I think in my own country, at first anyway, the roots would just be thrown away because it's not the camphor that they want. But in Taiwan, the skill of carving...And not only wood from roots, but other materials as well, has been well established here for many centuries.
老师刚刚用到一个字很棒哦，叫做 practical. Practical 这个字呢，通常来讲的是一个人啦，很务实，很知道说，哎，碰到这个事情，我们可以怎么处理 ？Practical. 那如果说今天提到说，哦，一般人，老师说，在这美国的话，可能这些树根就直接丢掉了。在台湾呢，大家想说，哎，这个树根可以干嘛？可以用一些实际的做法，让它产生经济的价值，也可以用 practical 这个字。这个字呢，是来自于 practice。practice 知道怎么拼是 practice。我们只要把最后这个 e 去掉，变成 al， 就会变成 practical 这个字来说明，好，这个人做事很务实、很实际的这种感觉。所以这边这个地方的话，他就告诉你说 ，these roots， 好，这些树根呢 ，provided artists with natural materials， 让这些艺术家有现成的、天然的这些材料 ，to carve all sorts of amazing things， 可以去制作出非常非常多让人惊叹的这些作品。
Okay, welcome back. Let's get busy. Wood carving in Sanyi broke new ground in the 1940s thanks to a man named Liu Dezun. One cold winter day, he turned a simple wooden mortar into a Japanese-style hibachi by adding a copper plate. So now we're going to take a look at how this modernwood carving industry really got started down in Miaoli County.
没错，所以我们来看一下这一段哦。这一段就告诉你说，三义那个时候开始木雕被大家注意到发光发热的这个时候是在1940年代。老师刚刚提到说呢，那个背景呢是好看，可能在打二次大战快结束了，然后到后面的时期1940。那二战的话结束于1945年嘛。所以在这边的话，我们看一下第一句话，他说。Wood carving in Sanyi, 就是在三义的这个木雕呢 broke new ground in the 1940s. The 1940s 代表这十年1940年代这十年，所以一定会加 s， 前面一定会有 the。Broke new ground 就是开始有开创性的突破，非常非常重要的这种进步等等。Thanks to a man named 刘德春，好，刘德春的这个男子，好，让这个三义的这个木雕被大家注意到。他说了。好 ，one cold winter day， 在有一天冬日的时候呢，好 ，he turned a simple wooden mortar into a Japanese-style hibachi by adding a copper plate。他呢就把这个他加装一片铜盘哦，让这个简单的这种木质的，好，就是那种 simple wooden mortar， 好，改造成这种日式的这种火锅 ，a Japanese-style hibachi。好，这个如果是日文的话，他们可能会念成 hibachi。好，它的重音会在第一音节 hibachi。那在这里的话，他提到是日式的火锅，等于是把它改装了之后，他说，哎，它可以变成一个非常非常实用的东西，到了户外你也可以烤火啊，让身体很暖和。
And he just said 实用 In the next sentence, we say this practical design was popular in Japan. Practical means it makes good sense to do something or use something or save something. It's useful.The design of this hibachi was popular in Japan. That's why we, even in English, we use the Japanese word to describe this kind of small stove that can conveniently cook things outside.
没有错。所以这里的话他就继续说了 This practical 就是非常实用的 design 设计呢 was popular in Japan 到日本之后呢非常非常非常流行。
Leo's success allowed him to set up a store known as the Baiji store in 1945. So from a very simple idea, in fact, he started a store. He opened a store and it was called Baiji
Hang.
Baiji and then Hang, of course, is store right in the middle of the 1940s in 1945.
Yeah, 所以在这里的话你就看到这句话说 Lose success 好他这样成功了一炮而红之后呢 Allowed him to set up a store 还有机会可以开自己的店铺这个店铺的名字呢 Known as the Baiji store in 1945 在1945年的时候他就开设了一家叫百吉行的店铺好变成店老板了
In addition to works of art, Sani's woodworking industry was commercially successful in selling practical items like furniture and plates. A work of art can be something made from almost any material you can think of that people appreciate for its look, not its use, but its look, most famously paintings. We don't.By a、painting by Degas or other famous、artists for millions and millions of dollars in order to、cover your window in the winter. We appreciate them for being to us just beautiful, beautifully designed and crafted. Well, this is not paintings we're talking about, it's sculpture or carving, which is also an art.Because we can take something which maybe doesn't look like very much and change a bit of it here and there. And、then people will say, oh, that's really cool. I want one. And it can become a business as well. Now, especially with large pieces of roots, and camphor trees are not small, so they have big roots. He could make benches, chairs, small tables, and other...pieces of furniture, as well as cooking implements like plates, things used to, what do you call
those? Spatula.
Thanks. The English is spatula. Hard wood we can use even in a hot pan. Spatula, S-P-A-T-U-L-A. S-P-A-T-U-L-A. So both practical...And artistic objects could be made, can be made from wooden roots.
没错。所以在这里的话，你可以看到说，第一个，看到这个 works of art。好，老师刚刚前面提到说，在这些樟树的这些根啊，它可以用作很多很多不同的东西嘛，可以拿来雕塑成艺术品。那艺术品的话，你就可以用 works of art。那通常提到这个艺术品的时候，它不是因为它的实用性，是因为它的美。所以老师刚刚提到说，你不会去买一幅很贵的这个艺术家画的这个画作，然后呢，然后拿来就是来挂在那个窗户旁边，有没有哈遮阳？你不会这样做，对不对？这个 works of art 要特别注意的地方是 work 平常的时候是不加 s 的，只有在碰到这种音乐作品、艺术作品啊，或者是艺术品等等，它才会变成 s works of art。然后这要特别注意一下，平常的 work I have a lot of work。即便有好多样工作，你还是用单数的，因为平常是不可数。只有变成艺术作品，好这些东西的时候，才会有机会看到它加 s。这是第一个重要的事情。后面他就提到说了 ，Sanyi's woodworking industry was commercially successful， 在商业上呢非常非常的成功。Commercially 就是在商业上的。然后呢 ，in selling practical items like furniture and plates， 特别注意一下 ，furniture 这个字也是一样。老师刚刚在解释的时候有提到 a piece of furniture， 你就知道 furniture 这个字它本身在使用的时候是不可数的。如果你要提到一件、两件、三件家具的话，你要讲 a piece of 变成它的一个量词。但是后面这个 plates 啊，它是可数的，它所以变成是说三亿在木雕产业，像是它的这个销售家具啊 furniture 不可数，板材啦 plates。 好，这方面这种实用的 practical items 还是获得了非常多商业上的成功。
In the 1950s and 1960s, Sanee was a popular tourist spot for American soldiers who were stationed in nearby Taizong. As we know, Miaoli and Taizong are right next to each other. And usually soldiers will be stationed in large cities because the transportation is more convenient to move them around. Anyway, Sanee was popular for American soldiers. It was a chance to get out of the city and, wow, Miaoli is so beautiful. The mountains, the forests, and the furniture, and so on. During that time, Sanee became famous for its wooden sculptures. A sculpture, the verb is to sculpt, S-C-U-L-P-T. That is to work with some material and change it from maybe a natural way you found it, change it into something that could be useful, practical, or a work of art.
嗯，没错。所以这里的话，我们来看一下这两句话哈。他说，在1950还有1960年代的时候呢，三一 was a popular tourist spot. A tourist spot 就是那种观光景点。这个字在翻译里面常常会出现啊。有时候你会看到 tourist attraction 也可以这样子使用。Attraction 的拼法是 attraction。Attraction, attract 就是吸引嘛。Attraction 的话也可以当作是观光景点 ，a tourist spot or tourist attraction。如果提到这个景点很热门的话，我们可以常使用这边使用的一个形容词叫做 popular。热门景点就是 a popular tourist spot。好，他说 for American soldiers， 对这个美国的这个军人，美军来说呢是非常非常著名的景点。Who were stationed in nearby Taizong？好，这台中的话跟苗栗就是在隔壁嘛，对不对？老师提到说呢，这个很多时候军人都驻扎在主要的一些那种城市，这样他们在移动起来会比较方便。在这里的话 ，who were stationed in 什么什么城市，就是在驻扎在那个位置。然后后面他这句就是想说 ，during that time， 在当时呢，三一 became famous for its wooden sculptures。sculpture 就是这些雕塑品，它是来自于动词 sculpt。这个字好，没问题的。然后 ，which made great souvenirs， souvenirs 就是我们常常讲的纪念品。所以说，今天驻扎在台中的美军，如果过来到苗栗逛一逛，想要带一些纪念品回家，好，之后可以回到美国去的时候给家人看的话，那就可以买这些木雕的纪念品带回去。好 ，which made great souvenir 就是可以成为很适合作为纪念品带回家乡美国。
Well, that's it for today's lesson, part one. Tomorrow, join us for part two and learn more about camphor and carving and Miaoli. Until then,
bye-bye.